story of the 1991 Permian Panthers actually starts in the fall of 1990, when the world was exposed to the good and the bad of the mojo tradition in Friday Night Lights, the best-selling book that left a sour taste in Odessans' mouths.
People felt like they were betrayed by Buzz Bissinger, because these people had invited my man into their houses. Gave him so much. They treated him with so much hospitality. I mean, this dude would go places and wouldn't have to pay for meals.
To add to the negative attention the book brought, the UIL put Permian on probation due to illegal preseason workouts, meaning the two lost Panthers could not defend their state and national championship from 1989.
We had already knew that 91, you know, we were going to be state champs. And it was one of those deals we predicted early on because of, you know, the way we had gelled in 90 with the bad publicity from the book.
The closer the season got, the more you started hearing it from the upperclassmen. And they took that and they used it as motivation.
As if the national finger wagging after the book and being barred from the 1990 playoffs weren't enough, some of Mojo's senior captains found extra motivation at, of all things, the Boys State program in Austin that summer.
Guys from big name schools were there. It was just me and Tony Daniels. We were just in their mouths 24/7. Mojo, you guys are not going to do this. You're not going to do that. And that day, I looked Tony dead in his face. I said, man, I can't wait to get back home. We went in state.
When we left Austin and went back, you know, it was one of those deals that pushed us even harder. We were like, you know what? We've opened our mouth. We said this. Now let's make sure that, you know, we follow through with it. And we felt like, you know, nobody in the country could beat us.
At the time, the expectations at Permian remained high. Continue the tradition of excellence. If they didn't know already, everyone knew what the goal was for 1991 when Tony Daniels and Malcolm Hamilton came back home.
We had already had our mindset set on state. It wasn't nothing else but state, and we weren't going to accept anything else but state.
And these Permian players had a strong connection. And while they weren't naughty by nature, they were willing to defend themselves and their teammates at any turn, which had them all asking the same question. You down with OPP?
Naughty by Nature came up with a song called You Down with OPP, right? And it's called Other People's Property. But when the song came out, we flipped the song. Are you down with Odessa Permian Panthers? And we all had shirts.
Yeah, I'm not surprised Tony said OPP. I have memories of him blasting that in the locker room quite a bit.
With a physical and dominating defense that embraced the song's lyrics, there's just time to hit it, the Permian Panthers were about to put the state on notice, one beat down at a time. Unlike the undersized and overachieving Permian teams of old, these Panthers were loaded with talent. Leading the offense was Stormy Case, a future A&M Aggie. He commanded a backfield with All-State running back and future NFL back Malcolm Hamilton and sophomore sensation John Williams. With a defense stacked with All-State performers like Tony Daniels, Brian Tucker, and Michael Comer, Mojo held opponents to single digits 12 times, including a demolition of Abilene High, where the Eagles only gained 11 total yards and did not pick up a single first down. While Fridays were the only day to show it to everybody, they made it a point to dominate every day.
Our practices was electric. I mean, it was only the strong was going to survive.
I would say physically, the offseason we had at Permian has been, I think, the most challenging thing I've done. And that includes a four-year stint at West Point, an eight-year active duty in the Army.
And so the wins kept coming. 10-0 in district champs, a 33-0 shutout win over Lee, and perhaps an even sweeter 44-0 win over the school that blew the whistle on their 1990 early workouts, Odessa High.
From that point, we knew. We was like, whoever stepped in front of us, it's a beatdown. It had become one of those deals where we knew we were going to stomp everybody lights out, and we proved it.
The stompings kept coming through the playoffs, where Permian met the number one team in the state, Arlington Lamar, one of the teams talking trash at Boys State, and thrashed them 25-7, holding the elusive Sean Walters firmly in check.
After we beat Lamar, I said to myself, yeah, this damn defense is cold.
After knocking off number one, Mojo beat Lee again and Waco High in consecutive weeks by a combined score of 72-15, and it was another trip to Irving to play for the state championship. And they were taking much more than a bus full of pads with them.
From the athletes, to the coaches, to the fans, to the faculty, I believe that everybody was on board.
After more than a year's worth of frustration and dedication, and after 15 wins, the Panthers arrived at Texas Stadium with a chance to put a city's demons behind them with just one more win. The only thing standing in their way was the San Antonio Marshall team led by future three-time All-Pro Priest Holmes. But it was a former All-Pro running back turned analyst who really got the Panthers fired up.
Eric Dickerson, he was a huge Priest home fan. He enjoyed the way Priest ran the ball, right? And I overheard him telling some guys, man, this team's gonna kill Permian. And I walked up to him and I told him, I said, I hope you don't put your money on me because you're gonna lose everything you got.
Tony Daniels didn't look so prophetic in the first half as Holmes ran for 100 yards and sent Permian to the locker room down 14-7.
That was obviously a really good San Antonio Marshall team with Priest Holmes. And they actually had they could only run the ball, and they did it exceptionally well.
We had been behind a couple of games, you know, leading up to that state championship game, and we fared pretty well. You know, we just go in halftime, make adjustments. So we didn't have any doubts going into halftime.
Malcolm Hamilton and the Panthers were right not to worry. The defense shut Holmes down and shut Marshall out in the second half, and Mojo scored 20 unanswered points. With the clock winding down, the realization brought out mixed emotions.
It's gonna give you goosebumps, man.
The only time that I've ever really got that feeling again after that was when I married my wife.
Sadness, because now it's over. I don't get to be with my brothers. We don't get to have this feeling every week.
As a kid growing up in Odessa, I don't know that I've had a better sports moment in my life.
And when the Panthers brought home the 1991 state championship trophy to Odessa, they never believed it would be the last one in Permian's esteemed football history.
We certainly didn't expect that, but, you know, I think the team plays hard, and the team's out there giving everything they've got, and we're, you know, we're proud of them, and we'll support them.
30 years later, most of the players have moved away. Some have unfortunately even passed on. But the 91 Permian Panthers still hold a special bond with each other. And it all goes back to the message their team chaplain preached to them before that season.
The main thing that I believe, while we're still so very close to this day, is back to Jerry Thorpe saying, one heartbeat. When you kind of get yourself, it became truly a brotherhood.